Okay, guys, here I go, okay? And please bear with me. You know me, I'm not the best necessarily. On TV, on the best of times, when I'm staring in the camera, I'm just going to be really transparent and really authentic with you, and I'm going to just tell you as it is. If it was a message to just the guys, it would be like a minute and over. But for all the girls out there, it'll probably be quite a bit longer, okay? And so, Father, help me. Now, I've got some notes here, just my wonderful team, Graham and Simon, who've been with me for years and years, okay? Graham for 19 years, Simon for about 15. So they've just, you know, we all sat together and did some notes. So I'm going to sort of read some bits, and I'm just going to just speak from my heart at sometimes because it is so emotional. And so I would say many of you, probably obviously you've seen the statement that we've put out. You know, we've put it out on our website. There's been a lot of secular media. There's been Christian media that have all said that Rory has stepped down from God TV because of what was described in that as a moral failure, okay? And as I said, today's program, it's for you. It's for our God TV viewers. It is for you. It's for you who we love and care about, and that you, we know you love and care about us and about the ministry, okay, as well. And the first thing that I want to say is, you know, on behalf of all of us, we are so sorry. We're so sorry, guys. I mean, it's unbelievable to me. It still feels... I've been saying to our team just behind there, even to my kids, you know, it's like I wake up in the morning. I mean, I do. Oh, wow. And it's like, it's just not real. It's like, oh my gosh, you know, I've been fine. I have to do this on live TV anyway. This is, you know, it's just real stuff, guys. It's a real broadcast. This is really what, you know, a real family. And it's like Rory and I, you all know you've watched us for like, what, 19 years. I've been married for 27 years, okay? We don't have a perfect marriage, but what I want to say to you today is we had a marriage like most of you. You know, we had a good marriage. We probably had 70% good. Some of it was great, and probably 30% that needed working on, and we needed time out and some ministry and counseling and some romance and a break, okay? I'm just being honest. But actually, I've just seen on my notes, before I want to say that, I want to say this is really, really, really important, okay? And this is from the Father, and this is absolutely, and it's not an excuse. Yes, we have to be Abraham's and David's and Gideon's and Daniel's and Joseph, and if God uses men and women and mandals. But beyond that, I really want you all to know, those who love God TV, that right from the beginning, that the cornerstone of this ministry, the cornerstone of God TV as this apostolic prophetic end time ministry, is our Lord Jesus Christ, and is the Holy Spirit, and is the Father. And that's why you see, I know many of you know this, the God bug up there, because God spoke to me all those years ago, you know, probably about 2 years into God TV, and I was saying, Father, you know, what's your badge, like Superman, Batman, Warner Brothers? You know, what can we do so that people, when they're in trouble or maybe, you know, about to commit suicide or addicted, they can just turn on in it and they know that it's your channel and that they can get help. And the Father said to me, he said, that's my name. He said, put my name up there as God. And this is God's channel. And truly, I believe that we're going to see, I'm going to go to the altar right at the end of the program and pray. But truly, I believe that we are all going to see that God is going to do something incredible. As hurtful, as painful, as devastating as this situation is, and that I'm going to explain to you. But, you know, God is still God, and he hasn't fallen off his throne, and the Father is sovereign. And he knew before the beginning of time that we would face this day and that we would be here tonight, you know, talking to you like this. And so this is built on the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. And Rory and I and our God TV team, we are stewards. We've been called to steward his vision on earth. That is our honor and our privilege. And so what I want to say is just for, oh, some of the stuff that's going around in the media. I'm just going to say it very, very briefly. I have never had an affair. We do not own two private jets that are parked in our backyard. We do not have a house in London. We do not have a house in America. Our present house, okay, is a 15-year leasehold. We don't own it. As I said, with our marriage, I think the most important thing that for you, our friends, you need to know that we had a good marriage. We really did. It's like Lois Scott's going to be with me later, and Steve Bright, and like, you know, Lois and Ken and I were together, and we were having dinner with Benny Hinn, and we were all saying, you know, the ministry marriages, we all have such spiritual warfare, but, you know, we had a good ministry marriage, and Rory and I did. You know, what you saw, you know, really, it really was what you got. We did, you know, there was no hiding behind closed doors, and I just really feel it's really, really important that you know that. And so last December, okay, I'm just going to backtrack a bit. We had an amazing family Christmas. It was beautiful. We did our house up beautifully. And my mom came down with a friend, and our kids were there, and Rory and I. And we had an absolutely wonderful time. It was amazing. And then in January, which was, some of you remember, with the Revival Center, we had the consecration with Benny Hinn. Now, this is really, really important. What happened was something incredible happened. And many of you might remember this because we did share a little bit. In January, Rory had the most incredible encounter with the Father. And in all, I've known Rory since he was 18, okay, 18 years old, and I was 22. And in all my life that I had known Rory, I had never, ever seen his life be so encountered by the Father, by the Father God himself. And he, as he called him Papa, he was having the most, it was just incredible, it really was. I mean, there were even some things, our team was so deeply touched by the things that were happening to him. I know they'll say amen there in the gallery. And our children were deeply touched by it. It was like a sort of 2 months where he would be worshiping God in his room and come out blowing the shofar. I mean, and I would want to, it would make me want to weep because I had never seen my husband like that, you know, in all the 27 years I'd known him. Because he's a practical man, you know, and this was an incredible spiritual encounter. And because I want to mention right now, Rory had been abandoned in the womb when he was about 3 months old. So he had never really known until he was 18, for the first 18 years of his life. He didn't know his real dad. And then he had had two other stepfathers. Pretty soon onto that, his second one that I know, who was amazing. But he'd had quite a lot of trauma and abandonment at a very early age, and then was very, very, very bullied also as he grew up in those early years at school. And therefore, many of us believe that Rory had really suffered like with an orphan spirit in his soul, you know, for a long, long time. But what happens is, you know, some of us, and especially men, you know, they don't trust so easily. When I was younger, I got inner healing for a lot of stuff and for everything, and I needed it. But men are different to us girls, you know, we're more open. And so Rory didn't, you know, he kept more private. He was very private, so he kept himself. So that's just to explain that. But a lot of you will remember that we had an amazing time at the Revival Center, at the Pavilions and the Revival Center. We dedicated it with Pastor Benny Hinn. I remember the anointing was so strong there. And I remember when Pastor Benny came in with Rory and I, and he said that he had not experienced, he'd only experienced that anointing when he'd walked into the anointing of the, I think it was the Carnegie or something, where Catherine Kuhlman was ministering. And I tell you guys, you know, right down there in the Revival Center by that altar, it was like that. The anointing was so amazing. And so God was just starting to just pour his spirit out on the ministry and on the Revival Center and on ourselves as a family. And Rory was having this amazing encounter. And then Rory went to South Africa, and it was very, very important for him because God was starting to like open up some stuff just to do with past things. And he went to the school where he was bullied. And I just want to say here that wherever Rory traveled aboard, Rory and I were totally, we've been best friends for 27 years. So, you know, we talked to each other or Skyped each other every night when he was away. And when he was there, I was just believing for healing for him. You know, we were excited. And that was how it was. Then in March, okay, we were in March and something happened. It was just like a few weeks afterwards, and Rory had been away and he came in the house, and I'm just explaining to you just the honest truth of just what happened. Okay, up till then everything had been, it had been like stable and just probably like a lot of your marriages, all right? And something, and I looked at him and he said something, and something had changed, and what he said, it went right there, and I thought, oh my gosh, ah, what is happening? And then he was in the bathroom and he just said, I'm going, and I'm going to France, or I'm going to Germany. He said, I'm going to ride the Autobahn, and he says, I'm going, I'm not telling you where I'm going. You've got no right to ask questions. I'm just going, or whatever. Now you can imagine, he just said, I need space. I need to find my identity, and I need space. I just need space. And I mean, I was, I mean, you can imagine a wife, okay? I was like, I just, my whole world started turning upside down. And the next morning he just went. And it started a pattern, and that was extremely, extremely traumatic. It started to be extremely emotionally traumatic for me, and to cope with emotionally, because suddenly my husband was just not, started to change in a pattern and a way I had never seen him act before. And as I said, I mean, I've known, you know, you guys, you've known your husband, some of you also the same, since they were 18, okay? And that is a long, long time. But I just thought, well, Father, I just, you know, I was being able, I was really, I just written vision from heaven, being able to be really strong with the Father at the time. And so me and some, I've got wonderful friends. They're all incredible intercessors. So about three of us, you know, I shared with them, and we just kept it quiet because we just believe, let's cover Rory in love, and let, you know, we just believe God for breakthrough. We just believe he's had such an amazing encounter. We're just going to stand. We're just going to believe the Father for the breakthrough of this. So that's what we did. And then it got worse, and it got worse, and Rory was away. He's just started to just go off, and I was just left. And then when Rory came back, then he started to say to me, you need to keep it quiet for the good of our staff and for the ministry and the viewers. And so I started to feel very manipulated, but intimidated. And then having to deal, you must understand, you feel like you, and then he started to say he didn't know if he wanted to be married or, you know, or not. And things, I could see things were happening with his soul. There was something, there was just something wrong. So we, I got hold of, Edsel Voso, wonderful, wonderful minister that we really trust, that I really trust, and just really, just start, I talked to him, and we really wanted to just see if maybe he would counsel us, or if Rory would go for counseling, okay? Sorry, I know this is long, I'm just trying to just tell you at the whole thing so you can understand and see the journey, okay? And of course, all of us, but all of us, we really, really thought that Rory was, and I believe he was having this terrible burnout after carrying the financial burden of the ministry, because it had caused incredible pressure on him for years and years. And our family had seen that, our children had seen that, those close to Rory had seen that. And so we just carried on believing for a breakthrough. And unfortunately, by that time, something had happened in Rory's heart, and he just would not, he did not trust anybody to go to counseling. He did not trust any minister for ministry. He did not trust anyone to go and share his heart for counseling. You must also understand that Christian television, in a way, we've got wonderful, wonderful people that you see on Christian television, but in the beginning years, it was a really cutthroat. Ministry can be cutthroat. And they can, you know, for Rory, I had seen that he'd been let down a lot, you know, by ministers. And I mean, the one thing Edsel Voso said to me when we talked, he said, you know, he said, we need to repent for the lack of apostolic fathers, you know, for visionaries, for apostolic visionaries like Rory and I and many others, because there's been a dearth of apostolic fathers that people can really, really trust, especially that the men can really, really trust. Anyway, so still, thinking that it was really just burnout, and Rory was still saying, I need space, just give me space. So he started going away for like weeks at a time. But it seemed like every time he had more space, it just got worse and worse for our marriage. And by that time, I mean, to live like that for me, I mean, it was really, really hard. Anyway, then I got taken into emergency on Global Day of Prayer for gallbladder operation, which actually the Lord turned to absolute amazing good, because I was so ill. They found that I had such an infection. It was almost septicemia, and my infection levels were sky high. And they found that that had been like seeping through my bloodstream probably for a year, maybe a year and a half, which is why after I'd been so ill with gastroparesis before, I hadn't got better. And so I was put on the NHS emergency list. They were wonderful to me. But what happened was that during that time, when I was so ill, I was in hospital, and Rory just flew off. And he flew off to Austria, and he would keep going to Austria. And finally, my brother, who's a doctor, I was so sick that my brother said, Rory, you need to come home now. You need to come home right now, because he never told me how sick I was, but he told Rory, he knew how sick I was. And Rory came home. He was back until, you know, I got out of hospital. 2 days later, after I was out of hospital, he just left me with friends, and he just went off. And he went off for 5 weeks. He didn't ask how I was. I was just left. Luckily, I went for 2 weeks to like a recuperative spa with nurses, which really, really helped me. And then God gave me my health back. But during that time, I mean, you know, for those of you ladies, you women who are married, you girls out there who are married, you can imagine. I mean, it's like I was like emotionally like in trauma, because my husband, there was something wrong. I didn't know what it was. It's like it just seemed to me, I said to him, some of the board and everything, we said, is there someone else? Is there another woman? No, there's no other woman. His only mistress was the Autobahn in Germany, you know. And it looked, you know, I thought, Father, well, maybe he's just going through a midlife crisis and burnout. But I'm going to stand for his destiny, and I'm going to stand for his life, and praying and believing the Lord, you know, for breakthrough. And let me just try and hurry it up. Is that throughout this, you know, we just wanted Rory, all of us, including the board, we just wanted Rory, you know, to get counseling, but he just wasn't in a position where he could receive any counseling or any ministry. On the 15th of August, which I know that date from Steve Beik, on the 15th of August, just through, you know, a lot of people, we were praying, Father, just expose things that need to be exposed, because something is wrong here, and you just, we need Holy Spirit, we just need you to expose things so that, you know, if it's a boil like a lance, we need to get it lanced. And it was that night that actually I found out, just through sheer coincidence, that Rory had been, what we later found, we found out the next morning, having an affair with a divorced woman in Austria. And very, very briefly, the devil got in very, very easily. We found out that he'd been asked to do by family friends. He'd gone and stayed with family friends who knew our children, okay, who'd met me. They had gone, I mean, Rory used to go like every January, you know, sometimes with the kids to ski. And we really, you know, family, we really trust, as you know, as well. And the father had asked the divorced daughter, who was a musician and a jazz singer, had asked Rory, because Rory and I used to be in music, we came from music all those years ago, to do her album. And Rory obviously had never said anything to any of us, because he didn't want to. And so what happened is, when I was 14 years old. I mean, Kim knows. Kim was a musician. We're going to hear from Kim Clement just now. Kim and I came from the same stretch of coast in South Africa. We were both born again, like in the club world. I came from the club world with singing and music, and I know what music studios are like. I was in music studios when I was unsafe, from when I was 14 till I was 19. And believe me, you get in a music studio, it is one of the most seductive environments that you can have, okay? That's where I was. I was saved in a club. I was saved from that world. So I know what that can be. So what happened was, as far as we can find out, Rory was doing this jazz album for this divorced woman who's 50. And obviously, I know what it's like. I mean, you sing through to the producer, okay? It becomes extremely seductive. Jezebel lands on it, that hook. And then what we also found out, and I'm being very honest here, is that we found out that this woman had said that she'd had an audible voice from God, okay, whether that's true or not, but she'd heard from God that Rory was her Mr. Right, that he was her husband. And so what happened was that my husband, that Rory, because of the mantle on his life, because as Kim Clemens said, he's called to lead millions. You understand? That's the truth. That the princes of hell designed a perfect strategy against him to hook his soul in. Do you understand? Through that seductive Jezebel spirit, and he got hooked in. And he did get hooked in. And what happened, that landed up in adultery. And so immediately that morning, the next morning, the board, you know, talked to him. And he just said, and Rory, what had happened is it was just too far gone. And Rory just said, I won't be controlled. He went upstairs, he packed his bags, and he left the house, the family house, and he went to Austria. And that's what happened. And then 2 weeks later, He said that he was cutting it off. He went to South Africa, and he cut it off and said he was willing to be willing. Then he came back a few weeks ago, about 2 weeks ago to Plymouth, 2.5 weeks ago. And, you know, we all thought, wonderful Father, you're gonna do something. You're gonna restore. You're gonna move. You're gonna really move in the situation. And then 4 days into everything, some of the leaks started coming out on the internet. And Rory just, he didn't have to. He didn't have to, guys. We could have come like Marcus and Joni on Daystorm. We could have sat before you and all worked it out. But Rory just said, I'm going to just step aside. And then he would say to me, and he'd been saying to me for many months, he said, I don't want to be in ministry anymore. You know, he said, I don't know if I want a divorce or not. I don't know if I want to get married, but I don't want to be in ministry anymore. It had been like something that, a real strategic attack against his mind. And he just didn't want to be in ministry anymore. And so he and I then went to South Africa the next day. This was about, 2 weeks ago. And hoping to have counseling with Andre and Cliff, our dear friends there. And then, like, he said he packed his bags for Jerusalem. We're meant to have sabbatical in Jerusalem here. And this is nearly the end story. It's fine. All you men, I know, don't like detail. But for the women, I'm just telling you how it happened. Because otherwise you're going to say, how can it happen? I'm still saying, how can it happen? And then what happened was we were one day in Africa. And then Rory just, after a day, he just looked at me, turned around to me. He left the ministry, and he just said, our marriage is over. He just said some other things that I'm not going to repeat. And he just said, it's finished. It's over. And he left me there with some friends, you know, at a place in the bush. And he just drove 70 Ks away from me. And that actually, they've known him since he was 15. They just said, you just can't leave your wife like that. You get back anywhere. I knew I had to just come back from London. It was too much. I'd been too damaged emotionally. It had been too long. And I had received a prophecy from someone called David Wagner a few months back. And in it, he had said to me, he didn't know anything. He just phoned me. And he said, Wendy, he said, the Father has said that enough is enough on your behalf. And he'd seen the Father stamp his foot, and the Father had said no. But then in that prophecy as well, later on, there was restitution and restoration. And so that is what I've been hanging on to and clinging to. And so from the statement, I know from the statement that many of you probably, which is, would have been obviously all of our desire, no one more than me, okay, that Rory was had just stepped aside from God TV for a time, and that we were going to have restoration and go for joint counseling and for ministry, and that our marriage was, you know, going to be restored, and that, you know, it would that's what we would do. But today I have to tell you guys, it is not like that. Rory is on this lady's father's farm in South Africa. He doesn't want to be involved in the ministry anymore in God TV. And as far as he's concerned, the marriage is finished and he doesn't want restoration. He doesn't want counseling. He doesn't want anything to do with it. And basically he wants a new life. And that is where, it's easy for me telling you that now. It's different when you go back to the hotel and you realize, I mean, I know this sounds dramatic, but you know what? When you've been married to someone for 27 years, it is dramatic because the thing is, it's like your life is over. You know, all my memories, I'm just talking personally from me, are with Rory since I was like 22 years old. But I want to say to you something now as well, is that through all of this, through all of these 7 months, through every single thing, is one thing that has never changed and one thing that has always remained the same and that will never change for me and that I've just seen is that God, the Father, to me, has been so faithful. He has been amazing. There's times when, like a little girl, I felt like he's carried me heart to heart. He's walked me through, I really mean it, in heaven. He's walked me through heaven and he's been carrying me like this on my heart, like that. Sometimes I've been, you know, he's just taken me by the hand and just, we've just been walking through the meadow. And he's just been healing my heart where it couldn't be healed. And as we've still been standing, for Rory. And I'm going to, you know, I'll talk about God TV just in a little while. So that's the situation. That's where it is. We, all of us, we still believe, you know, you're going to hear from Lois later, from Kim Clement, you'll hear from Cindy Jacobs, they all, and Kim has been really praying and fasting for Rory. Kim and Rory are good friends. Kim and Jane are our wonderful, wonderful friends. They know our family well. We love their family, okay? But believe me, Kim loves us. Kim and Jane love us, and they know us, all right? But what I want to say to you is that in all of this, I don't know what the outcome will be, but I do know this. I know this with all my heart because I know my Father, and I know it because I can't help. I've got absolute trust in my Father God. He is amazing. He is beautiful, and He is always good. He knew this was going to happen. I know, and I have absolute faith in my heart that there's going to be incredible restoration and incredible restitution in our lives ahead. I don't know how that's going to happen with Rory. I can't speak for that. For me, Rory Alec is on the altar. I have put Rory Alec on the altar. I'm not speaking for that in my life. What I'm saying to you is that God is so amazing, and that for some of you who have been through this yourselves or are going through it now, and have been, you know the pain involved. It's like Suzanne Hinn said to me, she said, Wendy, divorce is worse than death. And I can verify that it's true, okay? But I just want to say, that in all of this, I glorify the Father because He is amazing and He has been amazing to me. And He is my only strength. He is the only way that I'm going to be able to get through the next weeks and months. But one thing that I want to say is that I am totally, and my team, all of us, okay, we're totally committed to this apostolic prophetic mantle of God TV. Okay, actually I feel I should, I'm gonna do this now. I'm gonna pray later, but I want to just go here, if we can, just here, because I have to declare some things here. If my mics don't fall off, which I hope they don't. Are they on? Okay. Father, oh, I can feel the anointing, guys. Listen, I just need you to know this, and a lot of you do know this. I didn't get my apostolic media mantle to media from my husband, okay? When I met Rory, I'd been in drama and music. God had already put a call on my life, okay, to apostolic evangelistic media to reach 2 billion souls in my lifetime, I had a burning passion for the media. When I met Rory, that I already had the mantle and that burning call upon my life. When I met Rory, he was in the South African Army, and he was more in music then, okay? And then, you know, we started working together on a rock opera, and that's how it happened. But I felt that the Lord really wanted me just to share this morning, not because of ego, not because of anything, but so that you can understand. And a lot of you do know. I mean, the stuff you watch on TV with my team, okay, the content, that's what God has called and anointed me to do. I'm better off camera than in front of camera. I enjoy it more, okay? Because I'm a media girl, all right? I'm called to media, to make television, to produce what you see on God TV. That's what I've done for 19 years. That's my joy. So Father, I just thank you right now. Father, I thank you for the anointing, Father. For now, I am left here to lead God TV, Father, as a co-founder on my own. But Daddy, I just want to thank you, Father. I commit, Father, with the apostolic media mandate that you've put on my life, Father, to continue to steward God TV, Father. Father, and I'm speaking apostolically. Oh, yeah. Brokomaran, togomanahanda, gahanda, garahitikisina, hana mahama. Umboko semehin, ya drosta gahama, and gistigihin, ya nana, luguhosta, and me yato do, ya garamelahayana nanta. We fight against the prince. I know a lot of you understand it, but you need to hear me now. We war in the spirit in God TV. We fight against the prince of the power of the air. Okay, now the prince of the power of the air is the prince of the power of the airwaves. That's our mandate. That is the reason for this battle. That is the reason why the princes of hell have battled for Rory's soul. Okay, it's been a battle for Rory's soul. Okay, so Father, I thank you that our viewers are going to stand, Father, our wonderful viewers, and I call our prophetic intercessors. I call you to rise up. You know what's at stake. But Father, I just thank you in the name of Jesus. Father, I prophesy and I thank you, Father, and the prophets have already started prophesying that from this time forth, that there's going to be the start of a release of a prophetic fire and a prophetic glory and a prophetic mantle that's going to fall on God TV, that Haman, that is the devil, is going to be hanged on his own gallows for what has happened here, for this satanic assault against God TV and against Rory and I in the name of Jesus. And Father, and it's been prophesied that things that we will expand, that God TV will expand and explode, and that this mantle is going to have the fire and the glory of God like never before as a precursor to revival. And Father, I thank you for that. And Satan, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I come against you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Father, first I bow my knee to you, Father. I humble myself. And Father, I bow my knee to you, Father. I humble myself to you. And Father, not in any of my might or in any of my strength or our team's strength, Father, we come against you. But I tell you, devil, this attack is over. It's finished right now. And we serve you, notice, in the spirit right here from Jerusalem. We serve you, notice, in the spirit. There were prophets who saw you cowering earlier, and we say, devil, we are going to be very, very dangerous from this point on, even more dangerous as God TV, and we are going to stun hell in the name of Jesus Christ. And I'm just decreeing now that not only goes for God TV, but I'm speaking right now to the TV series as well that is about to come into being. That is 1 billion souls for the equipping of the saints. And now I speak that 1 billion souls in the name of Jesus Christ to the secular world in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And Father, we're going to pray for Rory later, Father, but we love him. And Father, we bless him, Father. We love him. Father, I get angry sometimes, but Father, I'm not bitter. Father, I bless my husband. Father, I bless him, Jesus. Father, I bless him, Jesus. I bless him, Father. I bless him, Father. I bless him, Father. Have mercy on him, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, deliver him in the name of Jesus. Father, we love you. We love you. We love you, Father. Father, you're our best. You're our best in the whole world, Father. We do this for you. We're our stewards. It's our great honor and our privilege. And Father, we thank you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And Kim Clement, our dear friend. Are you there, Kim?
Yeah, I'm here, Wendy. How are you?
Okay, Kim, please just say whatever you want to say.
Okay, first of all, I want to greet you and Rory, because I don't see him absent yet. So Amen. Until I see that, I'm not going to be speaking just to you. I'm speaking to him as well. My prophetic sense is that unless I see him gone, I can't address just you. And what you've just done is extremely noble, and your prayer is very, very powerful. And I see a woman standing seemingly by herself, but there are literally angels that have surrounded you all over. Just like Elisha, when he saw the enemy around him, and he saw the angels, I saw that and I felt the presence. That's what you felt. That's why you started praying. You know, the one thing I want to deal with just for a few minutes, and I'm not going to pull Rory down. Rory is my brother and my friend, and I know that he is listening. And I just want him, you, Rory, to know that God has required of you much, and to whom much is given, much is required. You're not just a businessman that's stepping down like a normal person, even though that's wrong. You're stepping down from one of the biggest media voices in the world that has had a vision to touch souls. And do you really believe that God is just going to say, "Ciao, Rory, you're on your way out"? That ain't going to happen. That I guarantee you. Now, he'll go to whatever measures he has to get you in your position and where he wants you to be. Now, one of the things that he put on my heart when I was praying, and I started praying a few weeks ago, and on the Day of Atonement, final judgment, the Lord told me that I was to fast and to separate myself that day after I did my broadcast and to pray and fast that whole day for you. And it came to me that until I, personally as a prophet, can see his absence and his seat not filled, there is a great hope that the Spirit of God will carry him back to where he belongs. Now, this is very painful for you, I know, Wendy, and I understand that, and I see you're putting on a very brave front, and I know that you trust the Lord. But there are curses that we understand, and we've got to be sober about this. The fact is, there's a generational curse that is carried through, and it's definitely attached itself to Rory, so that he would continue the family bloodline and what has happened, and that is to go to divorce. And what happens is when you make a decision like this, it then is a transfer to your children. And so that's the responsibility that we need to understand. This is a responsibility that every man faces, every woman faces, and that is whatever decision I make is going to affect the generations to come. We can say, well, God will cut that off and God will forgive me and God will cover me in certain instances, but when it comes to something as big as this, when you've been called to reach millions of people, are you listening, Rory? Millions of people, no, billions. This is a huge responsibility. And so when God called you to do that, there are decisions that you make, not just as a man who has a family or a business, but a man that has been given this most beautiful and sacred thing, to touch the untouchable and reach the unreachable. Our decisions make descendants. Now, when the children of Lot, the daughters, through unbelief and fear, impregnated themselves by their father, it wasn't the end of the story. Many, many years later, Jehoshaphat is faced by three nations. These three nations were the nations that were born from out of fear and unbelief. So in other words, our decisions do make descendants. And so this is a decision you need to think about very carefully. I'm your friend. I love you. And I'm fasting and praying for you. but my heart is broken because I know what's going on in your heart. And you need to think carefully about what you're doing, because I can see the outcome. And I want you to listen to me. That seat belongs to you. Now, if this woman has to do it by herself, she can and she will. There are many great women that have done it. It was Deborah, the warrior princess, who had to go and fight, and she won. And you know the story throughout the Bible. Rahab was the one that helped them take Jericho. Jael, she found a new use for a tent peg, and she was able to destroy the general, Sisera. And I can go on and on and on. There are great women that have been raised up that did it without men. You know, it's easier to prophesy and say, Wendy, you know what? God's going to anoint you because you are already anointed, and you're going to take this thing over. And if you have to, you will. But God TV is not going to go down. And so my word to you, my encouragement to you is this. I love you. I love Rory. I love your children. I love your family. And it was because of you, Wendy, that I actually did go onto Mount Carmel, even though Rory asked me. I know that you were behind it. You put the prophetic voice in Mount Carmel, put the prophetic voice in Jerusalem and in the Sea of Galilee, and millions of people saw it. It was my joy to do that. And I know that you wanted the prophetic in your life more than anything else on your network. And you did it. And there are many great prophets out there that God has raised up. But God called me to pray and to intercede. And the one thing I saw was, if you look in 2 Peter, I'm not going to preach a whole sermon. I'm just going to finish now, but I'm going to say this. In 2 Peter, it says in verse 10, chapter 1, it says, therefore, brothers, be even more diligent to make your call and your election sure. In other words, be sure of your election and your call. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. For so an entrance will be supplied to you into the everlasting kingdom. You know, we have a call and we have election. Our call we can stumble in. We can make mistakes. When it comes to our election, we cannot walk away from it. When you walk away from an election, you're literally walking away from God. I know you'll have many people that teach grace, say, well, God will cover you, it'll all be fine. And he will, he'll forgive you. But there are consequences. And now these consequences will begin to unfold. So I stand with you. I love you. I'm praying for you. And Wendy, you know, Jane and I, you've got us anytime you want. We'll be on the show. We'll do whatever you want. Just remember that.
Kim, thank you so much. We love you so much. Thanks so much.
I love you, Wendy.
Yeah, we love you too, hey. And love to Jane. Thank you. Thank you so much. We just have a little VT from Patricia King. She's been so wonderful. So I'd just love you to have a look at this. And then we'll be back here with Lois Scott, my wonderful friend, and Steve Beik.
Well, my name is Patricia King. I've been in Christian ministry now for almost 35 years, and I've enjoyed every single moment of serving the Lord, although some of the journeys that God has taken me on have gone into very dark places in the world, places where there's strong elements of antichrist spirit, of mission fields, where there is a lot of witchcraft, Satanism, and most recently, anti-trafficking and children at risk in the most horrific situations. These are very dark places, and it has warfare that accompanies it. You can imagine the amount of warfare going into a dark place, right into the center of human trafficking, etc., etc. And yet I have to say that in all the places where I've walked, because I'm not only a Christian minister, but I'm also a businesswoman, I've been involved in the medical field and in teaching realms, that I have discovered that media carries the most warfare and the most resistance of all the other places I've walked. Why would that be? Why would the enemy target this mountain of influence called media with more intensity than other mountains of influence? It is because whoever holds the airspace, whoever can communicate through media worldwide, can influence the mindsets of people. And so if we're carrying this precious gospel of Jesus Christ and the truth that has eternal life and eternal freedom and deliverance and salvation, we have this precious message to share. We can understand why he would want to resist that in the realm of media, in the cyberspace realm of the universe. I'm not making excuses for anyone that would make wrong choices in their life, to determine to follow a temptation instead of to follow the truth. And yet, at the same time, we have to understand that the human frame is sometimes frail, especially if there's been a lot of pressures and, you know, a lot of things that you face on a continual basis where you get worn down. So how then should we as Christians stand in an hour like this where we see leaders falter and fail in different areas? What does love look like in a time like this? Love always speaks the truth. Love doesn't compromise. Of course, we know that. But love also shows mercy, and love will pray, and love will stand, and love will continue to support. This is what love is. So in the process of things being sorted out and the things being brought back into alignment of determining what end is right and what end is wrong and how to reconcile it all, in all of that process, and it takes time, how are we going to stand with God TV? God TV was founded by the Lord. It's the word of the Lord being sent out of Jerusalem to the nations of the earth. We need to support in our prayers, in our financial giving, and in our belief right now what God is doing in the earth today through media. So many moral failures. It's sad. Every single one of them is sad. And we need to pray for our Christian leaders. And we need to pray for God's wisdom on how to move forward, on how to be uncompromising in our stand, in the truth that we speak, and the morals that we live by. And so what I'm asking for right now is for love in action. I'm asking that we, the body of Christ, would love like we've never loved before. A love that covers, a love that prays, a love that gives. Can I ask you right now to keep Rory and Wendy, their family, and all of God TV in your prayers? And they're going to need your love like never before. This is a big shaking that's going on, and God is going to sort it out because God loves us all. He loves Rory, he loves Wendy, he loves God TV, and he is at work within this to sort it all out. Can we, as their family, as others in the body of Christ in whom are called brothers and sisters, take them on our shoulders at this time and carry them through with love, with truth, with prayer, and with giving? I'm asking you to consider how you can support at this time and how we can win this battle, how we can conquer this mountain, how we can possess and occupy this great mountain of influence, this media mountain that is operating now on a global scale where the Word of God is reaching all the nations of the earth practically all at the same time. What a day that we're living in. It is a great day. It is a great hour, and we haven't seen anything yet. The latter glory of the house is going to be greater than the former, but we're in a battle right now that we need to win. Let's win it well, and let's win it together.
Thanks so much, Patricia. That's right. We really do believe the latter glory of this house. Hey, Lois.
Yeah, we do.
Thank you so much. I'm so glad to have my wonderful friend, Lois Gott, with us today. And I just want to say, Lois, I just want to say I have three wonderful friends, and I want to mention them, who have really, they've been just incredible, okay, to me. One is Marilyn, who will not come on air. She's in the boardroom. She'll be 70. She'll probably be cross me for saying that. She'll be 70 next year, and she lives in Patna in Scotland. She's Scottish, okay, and she's been Rory and I, our personal intercessor, for 19 years. That is a long, long time. And then the other one I want to say is Liz. Liz, I don't know if you're watching, my beautiful friend Liz Wright, who I adore, who is down there in Guildford, I think. Liz stayed with me when I was so ill day and night for almost 6 months. It was just incredible. God is just, you know, he's just friends. I mean, you know what that means. I just can't thank the Lord enough. And Lois, okay, is one of my other wonderful, wonderful friends. And I want to say, guys, when I am When I came back from Africa and I was in such a state, and this might sound funny, but it's not. Lois and I were in our pajamas, okay? I arrived at the Sofitel Hotel, and Ken was so wonderful. And Ken would like be coming in and out, like praying, you know, for us and Lois. I'd be phoning and she'd be coming down like all hours of the night and whatever. And that's, you know what? That's real love. That is just real, real love. Yeah. So Lois, it's wonderful. It's a great privilege to have you as mine. Just share what's on your heart, please.
Well, first of all, it's amazing to hear you tonight.
Yeah.
Because obviously we've been friends over 19 years.
Sunderland.
I remember you arriving in Sunderland, you and Rory, and buying the house next door to us, or at least renting the house next door.
Yeah.
And coming with a camera. And 3 hours of television.
Yeah.
And how the Lord has really anointed you for the task. And actually, I do know, having seen behind the scenes, just how much you carry yourself with the programming and the creativity and everything else. And we bless you, Wendy.
Thank you.
We're with you. But also, you know, I've listened tonight while you've shared very personally, very honestly. And I've been there with you through the darkest days.
I know.
And seen the tears. And to see how the Lord is helping you right now is astonishing, as well as the wonderful people that you do have around you. And I was struck this morning when I was reading about how the Philistines thought they had a great battle when Saul was lost. And it says that the men of Jabesh-Gilead rose up, valiant men rose up, and then they fasted. And I just, listening to Kim right there, I felt it was time for us, all of us who pray, all of us who should pray more, to rise up in valiant, with valiant intercession for God TV, for you, for Rory, who we love, and fast. And really declare that we're going to do that. But the other thing I wanted to share with you, we've talked about revival. You know, together we walked through some amazing things in Sunderland. But often heartache is the precursor to revival. Like, God loves to come to the brokenhearted.
Yeah.
And the scripture tells us in Psalm 84 that the valley of Baca of weeping will produce springs. And God says, I will strengthen you through the valley. And we just pray, Wendy, that you will be strengthened through this valley.
Amen.
And that springs will come, and springs to this ministry.
Amen.
And that, you know, whatever the outcome, we really pray, but we rise valiantly, but we declare that through this valley of weeping, God will produce springs.
Amen. 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 Do you want to share a bit about just about Ken and Rory and the hands?
Well, you know, we had dinner with you and Rory just before you went to South Africa.
Yeah, just 2 weeks ago.
And I just want to say, Rory, if you're watching this, we love you. We've been friends 19 years. We've been neighbors. I love your children. What wonderful children they are. And many years ago, at the first conference in Sunderland that you came to, there was a prophet from Australia, and he called Wendy and Rory up to pray for them, and then did something that was so embarrassing for us, hosting the conference. He slapped Rory across the face, and it was hard. It wasn't like a soft tap, it was hard. And then he took Ken's hand and Rory's hand, and he put them together, and he said, one day, you'll need each other.
I know.
And then many years later, we were in Colombia together. Mm-hmm. And the pastor there, just out of the blue, he took Rory to the platform and he asked Ken to come up. And he put their hands together and he said, one day, you'll need each other.
And it hasn't happened yet, has it?
And so when I was coming here, Ken said to me, it is my prayer that one day I'll take his hand and lead him back.
Yeah. Yeah. That's wonderful. Would you pray? Would you pray right now, Lois? Lead us in prayer, please. Thank you, Father.
Father, we thank you so much for your love. for your grace, for your mercy. We declare and we know that you walk through valleys of weeping with us, and you do produce springs in the desert. And right now, we thank you for Wendy. We bless her. We thank you for strengthening her and binding up the pain in her heart. We thank you for the children who are amazing. And right now we pray also for Rory. And we pray that that day will come where that prophetic act will come into being. And we pray for the staff and the team here. And we thank you for them. And we know that Wendy, she has an anointing. She's creative, she's clever, but there are awesome people around her too to carry this on. But Father, we right now we ask you to come. Raise up valiant warriors who will fast and pray. Be with Wendy. Be with the team here. And be with Rory.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Steve, anything you want to add?
Well,
Mr.
you know,
Beik?
Wendy, it has been a very difficult time. Andrew got it just right when he opened today. And everyone within God TV has been so supportive of everything that has been happening.
Yeah.
And they've been standing with us, and they've been doing their jobs, and they were come to work every day and so forth. And it is very difficult because I haven't been with you and Rory for 19 years, but I've been with you for a number of years since the beginning, really. OCC, Pastor Benny's then church.
That's where I met you.
That's right, exactly.
That's right.
And my wife and I were very active in that church, but it's very difficult because I too am very, very close to Rory.
Yeah.
I've traveled with him. I've gone everywhere with him. We've helped each other. And when this happened, it was a shock to everyone. And I know it's a shock to all of you.
Yeah.
But my wife, who is a pastor,
she's
and
wonderful.
An intercessor.
She's just amazing.
And she said, first of all, she was prophetic, and she said, before this happened, what had happened. But she also said that God is going to have his way, that Rory has to go through this period of time, but he's coming back. And so not just the management, not just the board, but pretty much everybody at God TV is standing on that, is standing on the fact that Rory's time will come. God will hit him over the head or whatever he has to do, and he'll be back here with God, with Wendy, more importantly, and with God TV.
Graham, as you're not speaking in my ear, thank you. Is Cindy Jacobs on the line? Thank you for telling me, kind of. What does that mean? Oh, the Skype seems, or maybe, can we get Cindy on the phone then? Okay. Our pilot there in the cockpit, Graham, who's been... let me just tell you something. Graham, our team, okay, behind the scenes. That, you know what? It's like having a second family because Graham has been with me, truly, from the first week. Graham, did I meet you the first week we ever started? Or the second week?
Second day.
First week. That's 19 years, okay? Wow. So Graham is my right hand. He's been there for 19 years. And Simon Dillon, you know what? I'm going to be awful. They're going to hate me for this.
He may be
but
running.
You know what? Do you know why I'm going to do it? Because I want to tell you guys that...
He's running out of the building.
No. You mustn't run out the building. Let's go. Okay, are we in here? Okay, all right. Okay, they're going to hate me for this, all right. But I want to tell you guys, listen, can you see can you come this way, Dan? And then we can get like a good view of everybody here. This is Luke. Luke's been with us how long, Luke, from Sunderland?
15 years.
Oh, 15 years. Okay, Steve, Mr. Big Steve, we love you. How many? 99.
Whatever.
What's that?
Oh,
brilliant saint.
Oh. 15 years.
15 years. Okay. Okay. Yes. I wonder who that is. Are you going to say anything nice? No. This is great. Can I just say why I'm showing you tonight? Is because, you know, for me to come in here, this is like, there's so much our family, you know, after working with them for so much, and I want to cry now. Lil, I know you as well. This is my beautiful Lil. Lil and I, we met you and Mick, yeah. Sort of almost in Sunderland when we started, didn't
18
we?
And a half years
18
ago.
And a half years ago, okay. These are all people, they love us, they love Rory, yeah. Okay? All of the people in here. This is our team. And so I just, you know, I know. Lil and I have been crying, I know. I just, you know, I just want you to know. That's real, okay? And that these are wonderful people, and these are some of the people behind the scenes, and that they, God TV carries on,
yes.
Because, hey, because it's God.
Yes.
You know, even Graham says that. He's an teasing.
Amen.
This is my daughter, okay, Samantha. Sam, are you going to say hi?
Hi.
Oh, Sam. It's my beautiful daughter. She was so beautiful, and I just want to say that when I was finding it so difficult before coming on air, this one, she just was so funny and helped me laugh so much in it, didn't you?
Always.
Always, I know, because we're weird, but anyway, there we are. And here is Dudy. Dudy is from Israel, but he does the best lighting, and he's done our lighting. How long for, Dudy? How many years? Long time.
Almost
10 years, I know, and he's Dudy is part of us. He's one of us here. And this is Jorg. Jorg, what do we call you? You are our engineer, yes, and you've been with us for how long? A long time.
I came 2000, January 2000.
2000, that's 14 years as well. I know, this is all our wonderful team, you know. And this, well, you've seen Trevor before, okay, Trev. Okay, Trev was from the BBC. Trevor is amazing. He edits so much of what you see on TV. Trev, how long have you been with us?
14 years.
14 years. It's incredible. I promise you, this is why we say our God TV team and crew are our family. And I'm now. Who am I getting to now? Now I'm getting to my other right hand. Okay. Graham is my one. This is my other right hand. Graham does production. This is network planning, programming and planning. Yes. Would you come on? Come
hi.
On. Just say hi.
Hello.
How long have you been with
17
us?
17 years.
Tell everybody how much you like live.
Oh, live TV is great. I love it so much. I live for it.
Oh, he hates it. He tried to produce us live once, and he was so, he terrified Rory and I so much, and we were going, oh my gosh. Anyway, but then now we have Simon and his amazing network planning team. They look over all the schedules, everything you see on TV. So a lot of these guys are people who have been, well, my team, years and years and years, and a lot of them have you found Zara, you married Zara and
I did, yes.
You did,
yes.
And Graham married Janice, I know as well, I know. Anyway, so have we got Cindy back now? Is she on the phone? See, this is what he does. Let me just show you this, okay? He sits back like this, look at this, how comfortable this is. Yes, this is, only a cynical Brit can do this. And now have we got Cindy on the phone? Have we got a photo?
Yes.
All right, that's great. Then I'll go back to studio because it's very important what Cindy has to say. Okay.
Hi.
Hi, Cindy.
Well, I can't see you, but I'm sure you're looking lovely.
Oh, it's fine. You're looking lovely. We can see you. Since, please just share your heart. Will you just share your heart? And after you share your heart, just will you pray with everybody? Would you do that?
Yes, I would be glad to.
Thanks so
much. Well, I want to tell you something. I mean, I was sitting watching, weeping. Maybe you heard me say that. And here in this hotel room in Northampton and just weeping. But all of a sudden, a surge of joy has just hit me. And I want to speak to the God TV family because the Holy Spirit came upon me in a dream. He said, talk to the God TV family. And I want to talk to you. I want to say something to you. The Lord said to me, first of all, no person built this network. God built it. And he is the foundation. That's what he said to me very, very clearly. He said, I am the foundation, and you tell my people, if they will stand behind Wendy, that God is going to do a work that you cannot imagine. And I don't know, Rory, if by some miracle of God you're watching, I love you too forever. But the Lord showed me that the media anointing that God has given you, Wendy, this Isaiah 52, how beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of them that publish the good news, that this has been the battle. This is a real battle about you going and the books you've written, the trilogies, going to literally, this is the only way to get the billion souls. It's got to go to the new level. And the Lord would say to you, daughter, I have anointed you and I have appointed you for this battle. And the Lord would say, the angels that you wrote about, even Michael the archangel, is even now doing battle on your behalf from Mount Zion, says the Lord. And the Lord says, know this, my angels are greater than any demon on the face of the earth. The Lord says, I will summon my power as in the days of old. And the Lord says, understand this, Gabriel, the messenger angel, is going to go forth from Mount Zion with this media anointing to publish the good news. Wendy, you listen to me. You know God has anointed you for media, for film. The Lord showed me that this is not only about our God TV family rising up for television, but it is a much broader media anointing. And this is very important to understand. I feel the Holy Spirit all over me right now. I want to say, this is about the Lord showing heaven, bringing heaven to earth. The Lord visiting, releasing what God showed you prophetically. And I mean, we were with you, Wendy, when you were trying to write the last book. And you remember you fell. And I mean, you just kept soldiering on. You just, because you're that, I always call you God's warrior chick, because you just kept going. And the Lord said, God TV family, you are not to come under a veil of sorrow, although this is extremely difficult, and we are going to keep warring for Rory. I'm standing totally in faith with Kim that he is going to be there. But I want to say to you, nevertheless, and there's a lot of neverthelesses in Scripture, nevertheless, the Lord says, those pictures that I showed you in your visionary experiences, Wendy, when I caught you up, I'm going to do that in movies and film. And God TV family, I want to say to you, we cannot let this platform go that has been built, because this is a foundation God is going to use. I want to say to you, God is going to use this foundation in a way that is, the revival is so big. It's so big. Listen, this is about souls. It has always been about souls. From the very beginning, this has been about souls. And I want to do something, and I feel the anointing to do this. I want to bind and break the spirit of grief. Listen to me, my beloved family, in Africa, in India, in Asia, many I've seen face to face recently in my travels. I want to speak to you. Do not come under the spirit of grief. You are to rise above this. I want to say, we are going to rise above this. By the name of Jesus, I bind it off you, Wendy. I bind it off you, Lois, all our family, all the God TV family. We're family together. We're going to do this together. We're going to bring heaven and earth together. I know this is the Holy Spirit. And I want to say, even as we pray, listen, all over the world, let's have a great prayer meeting today. What Patricia King said is right. You're fighting against the prince of the power of the air right now. And I, like I said, you know, I agree with Kim. I agree these other words. But I want to tell you, we're going to take the battle to the heavens. What if all over the world we have a great prayer meeting? Now, we're going to pray for Rory, but we're also going to pray for something that God has been trying to do. Remember, Wendy, when I gave you the word of the Lord from Chuck Pierce's, and I said, it is time for the films. It is time for God to release the next anointing. Wendy can't do that alone. Even Rory and Wendy couldn't have done it alone. It has to be us. We are family. You know, I'm looking at you all across Great Britain. I'm sitting in a hotel room talking to you. And I want to say, don't let Satan cause us to fail. We cannot fail. We're a body. This is what God has called us to be. We are not weak. We're a body. And there is a battle raging in the heavens. It's very violent. Listen, there's violence trying to come into our land. There's violence trying to take us out. Terrorists worldwide. But I want to say to you, God is a mighty man of war. The captain of the Lord of hosts is arising. Michael is doing battle. Angel is... Gabriel is sending messages all across the earth, and we're going to win. That's the bottom line. I'm on fire. We are going to win. Hey, Wendy, are you hearing this? You are going to win. We are going to win. The devil is a loser. He has always been a loser, and we're going to release beautiful things from the mountain of the Lord, and what we're going to do, and I'm going to come help you with this. We are going to start one of the prayer movements on the face of the earth. This is going to go to the next level. We're going to have 1 billion souls. The money is going to come in. If you were giving money to a man or a woman, you're always going to be disappointed. No, this is kingdom money. This is a kingdom channel. This isn't about some, all the prognosticators or whatever that word is, that would say, oh, it'll never work now. You're damaged goods. I say that's a lie from the pit of hell. It makes me so mad. I have this holy indignation right here in this chair in this hotel room. No, we're going over the top because we're family and we are going to pray the prayer of agreement. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus. We bind the prince of the power of the air. We bind powers of darkness. We bind the rulers that think they are going to steal 1 billion souls, that the body of Christ cannot rise up together. We cannot take this media mountain. No, we're going to do it for every continent on the face of the earth. Satan, if you wanted to do this against Rory, you should have tried it years ago before we became such a great army. And we do pray for Rory. And we command the veils of blindness to fall off your eyes, Rory Alec. You remember who you are. You remember whom you serve. You remember that it was God. You bowed your knee as a young man. And you gave your life so you can do what you want with your life, even more than I can do with what I want with my life. So, Father, we ask the warring angels to go forth. And we thank you that we are always called to be triumphant. Well, there it is. Whoa. Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit. Come upon every wounded heart, every disappointed heart. Come on, let the Holy Spirit Amen. Come upon you right now. Amen. Let the Holy Spirit come upon you. I'm feeling this joy well up inside of me. I'm speaking to you as a mother of the Lord. Let it rise up. Let it rise up. Let it rise up in Jesus' name. Well, I love you guys. Thank love you, God. You so much.
Yeah. Love you too, love Cindy. You. Thank you. You're such a blessing. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Father.
Wow, I don't know what you're feeling there, but in this hotel room, the presence of God is amazing.
We feel the anointing. Amen. Amen.
Love you.
In the desert.
Amen.
Love you. More, Lord. More, Lord. Come on all over the world, wherever you are. Yeah.
Thank you, Father. Let's go to the altar. Let's just go to the altar. Can you call Andrew into the altar? Yeah. We'll go to the altar. And keep Cindy with us. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
The oil of joy for mourning. That's what we decree right now.
Amen.
Listen to breaker. anointing is right here. The breaker anointing is greater than what the devil has tried to do. Listen, in the name of Jesus, Psalm 2:8 says this, that the Lord laughs in derision. Do you hear that? Enemy of our soul, God himself laughs in derision at the things that you are trying to do. And we declare, ask of us, we're asking you for the nations. Lord, we want to give nations. We want to give nations as your inheritance. I'm sorry I can't see you to know where you're moving, but thank you, Lord. Can you bring that over to me, please, that what you're watching over there? Yeah, thank you, Lord. Let's see if I can get a screen and just be with you. Listen, I decree this, why do the nations rage and the people plot a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel against the Lord, against his anointed, saying, let us break their pieces, their bonds in pieces, and cast their cords from us. And for he who sits...
Where's Cindy? Have we lost Cindy?
Oh, it is wow. Time for the valiant
Thank you,
to arise.
Father. Father, guys, there's such an anointing here. Person, I can really feel. Andrew, would you pray?
Yeah.
Please pray.
Can I pray also in Aramaic?
Oh, please. Oh, yes, please do. Please do. Wow.
The glory of the Lord is here.
Yeah.
And first of all, I cut off this nonsense that this is going to pass to our Christian and Samantha. It is not. God's blessing is upon Christian and Samantha forever. Ooh. They are yours.
Yeah.
They are children of the kingdom, children of the glory. Wow. And God's glory is upon you, Wendy.
Yes.
You know, tonight is no ordinary night. It is Sukkot.
Ooh.
It is Sukkot. And around us, we can see everybody building their sukkahs, and you have the roof open so the glory of God Amen. Can pass down.
Amen. Amen.
The glory of Amen. God will pass Amen. Down on you, Wendy,
yes.
on God TV,
yes.
on Samantha,
yeah,
on Christian,
yeah.
and upon all of you watching.
Yes, amen.
God's glory is amen. For you as well.
Amen.
Come, Lord amen. Jesus. Come amen. In your glory.
Yes. Amen.
And I'm going to pray God's blessing now in Aramaic.
Wonderful. Lovely.
The language that Jesus used here in this land.
Thank you.
Shemit Bahaba Brona Kosha Broha Ha'alaha Amen. Come, Lord, in your glory.
Yes.
And descend on us now.
Yeah.
Descend on Wendy.
Yeah.
All the pain, all the brokenness of
yes.
this place,
mm.
take it away.
Amen.
Because yeah. the Lord is here.
Yes. Yeah.
His Spirit is with us.
Yeah.
Allahumma ana.
Mm.
The Lord is here.
Amen.
His Spirit is with us.
Amen.
His Spirit is on you, Wendy.
Yeah.
Oh, shianda lakaba shonda, yanda lakaba shonda, yanda lakaba shonda.
Yeah.
Oh, shianda lakaba shianda lakaba shonda, yanda lakaba shonda. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Yeshua. Thank you that wow. you are with us now.
Yes. Wow.
And your glory is coming through the cloud. And your glory will not leave us.
No. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Graham, if we could just play Ben and Vera. Okay. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Father, we just bless every viewer. Thank you, Father, for our viewers. Amen. Thank you, Andrew. That was so beautiful. Amazing.